So let's see how much time we have to talk to Aisha very quickly on Sports Tonight. Aisha Falode, thank you so much for joining us on Sports Tonight this beautiful Tuesday. Well, congratulations. We are champions again of women's football in Africa. What kind of a challenge is this victory going to be posing to you as the newly appointed chairperson of the Nigerian Women Football League Board?
Thank you very much, Tony. Good evening. Let me say congratulations to the Super Falcons and their handlers, Coach Florence Omagbemi, her assistants, and the backroom staff, and for all the Nigerian fans who really and truly supported the girls while they were in Cameroon. Women's football on the continent of Africa has grown both in stature, profile, play, followership, and the fan base is huge. I have followed this tournament for the past 9 seasons. Cameroon was the 10th one. I have never seen before what I saw in Cameroon. What I saw in Cameroon in terms of the play, the quality, the gap between Nigeria and the rest of Africa is so slim now. It is very, very slim. And the fact that Nigeria has won this tournament 8 out of 10 tells you a lot. It tells you that we have been dominant enough on the continent of Africa, and that this time around, the other African countries are not sleeping anymore. They won the crown, which was why you saw the Lionesses were actually weeping and crying, even as they shook the hands of their president on that podium when the cup was being handed to Nigeria and when they were being given the silver medal. And then the fans too were not, they didn't like it, but they were true sportsmen and women. And we must commend the Confederation of African Football and the Republic of Cameroon for putting on such a spectacular show for women's football.
How do we ensure that we put structures in place and then revamp the women's game in Nigeria?
What Nigeria is going through now is a big challenge for everyone. The economic climate is not going to be supportive, or it's not going to be easy for anyone to want to continue with what was in the past 2 or 3 years ago. It is left for us now to be creative in terms of either sitting down with the clubs, really. A lot of clubs are owing their players. Some of them don't even have structure. What they have is an ad hoc arrangement. You know, you have a game at hand, you either go and play it or you sit out the game. Even your games at home, you can't honor because of financial constraints. And don't let us forget that most of these clubs are owned by state governments. How do we sit down with governments and begin to let them know that if they must run these clubs, they have to run it as a business. We have to run it as a properly managed, you know, organization that has a structure from top to bottom. You know, people are answerable to people. You as a head, as a pyramid, the top of the pyramid, also now have to think outside of the box. How can you, with these economic the challenges that we have now, what can you do to still support the game? In spite of the fact that we have challenges, the other African countries, their games seem to be thriving. You know, I sit down and I talk with the other heads of women's football from across the continent, and I hear, you know, we just started the league. We've signed a contract with the Kenyan Football Federation has just started their own women's league, and their women's team came to represent in the CECAFA region in the Africa Women's Tournament. They already have sponsors. You know, their game is thriving. And we cannot have been at the forefront. There will be no excuse to now take the back seat. If we are inaugurated, the first priority would be to sit down with the clubs, you know, really find out what the challenges are. If we do not know, we would only be thinking from outside of the ring. Until we get inside the ring, we cannot know what the challenges are. until we know what those challenges are, then we will know how to help the structure change.
Well, Aisha, we must say a very big thank you to you for speaking to us on the show tonight. We wish you the very best with the new assignments and whatever role we can play to help you achieve success on this new position. You can be sure we'll play that role for you all the time.